Hey, how's it going? So this week I am super pumped to kick off our 6-week series covering Notion MCPs, which stands for Model Context Protocols. And in English, what the heck that is you can think of it as Notion setting up a gateway for large language models, such as Claude, such as ChatGPT, to access all the data within our Notion workspaces. And not just access the data and read the data, but actually take action within our Notion workspaces for us based on the prompts that we give it. Such as, I could say, hey Claude, create a task within my Notion database. You look over here and you would see a new task pop up with the details that I've given it. Bunch more cool use cases that we're gonna cover in the next 5 weeks, but first off, I wanna show you how to set this up in 5 minutes, totally free. Let's go ahead and dive in. So first things first, we're gonna wanna download Claude for desktop. All you'll need to do, go to this URL, pick your operating system, Mac or Windows, and download. If you don't already have a Claude account, that's okay. You can create a free account, and what you get on the free account is all that you'll need for this setup. So step two, I've got a link to a Notion template that we'll be using here in the coming weeks. Highly recommend that you duplicate this to your Notion workspace. You can click the link, you can navigate to the duplicate button and get that set up for yourself. Okay, so step three of this setup is setting up an integration within your Notion. So navigate to this URL. I'll have it linked down below in the newsletter. You'll click new integration, but since I've already set this up, I'll select the one that I've set up. First thing you want to do is give it a name. Claude MCP would be a perfect thing to name it. And just scroll down and make sure that these three capabilities are checked. Both the ability to read content, to update content, and to insert content. If not, make sure they're all selected. Click save if you need to. Next, you'll go over to the access tab. You can see I already have my one individual page that I'm offering you as a template linked. You know, you may be a bit more laissez-faire than me. I just want Claude to have access to this one page for the time being, but you could grant access to your entire workspace if you'd like. But to set up access to this page, if that's what you'd like to do, you can click, I think yours will say add access. Mine says edit, of course. Select that page and you're rocking. Cool, so next step to this is going and downloading Node. You don't need to know how to code or know any JavaScript. You just simply need to download this. This sets up a local environment for us to run the Notion MCP server on your device. Nothing to worry about there. Just select your operating system, download similar to how we downloaded the desktop Claude app. And that's it for that step. So final step for you. We're gonna go to the Notion MCP server GitHub repository. We're gonna scroll down a little bit here, and we are gonna find this code right here under the adding MCP config to your client. You can copy that. Now we will jump back over to our desktop and go ahead and fire up Claude if you haven't already. After you've got that fired up, let's go ahead and click the Claude button up top. Let's click settings. Go to the developer tab, edit config. It should auto select this file in particular for you, Claude desktop config.json, but if not, go ahead and select that. Right click and go to open with. Now, if you're on a Mac, you'll have text edit. I don't know what the file editor, the default file editor is for Windows operating system, but that's what you'll want to select. So in this case, I'll select text edit. And when you open this, it'll be blank. Mine's not, I've already added the code. Yours will be blank. Just select, you'll most likely have two brackets. You can delete the two brackets. Drop in the code, and the code here is what we copied directly from GitHub. Drop that code in there. Next, go back to that integration that you set up within Notion. And what you'll want to do, I'm not going to show you mine, but you'll want to copy the entire secret key that you've developed here. After you click show, this button will change to copy. Copy that. Come back over here and find NTN underscore. There ought to be 4 or 5 stars after that. Of course, I have my key in here that I'm going to change after this. But copy those stars and you'll want to make sure that's where you post the secret key that you've created. And then take a second look at it, make sure there's no extra characters or spaces. It should be NTN underscore and your specific key. And then after you've done that, you'll save this file. So if you're on a Mac, Command S, and you can exit out of these other windows. And we'll go ahead and quit out of Claude. We're gonna restart it here. Cool, so after restarting Claude, within 5 minutes, here we are. We've set up a super, super cool addition to our Notion workspace. And like I mentioned, over the next 5 weeks, I've got some really cool use cases for you that we're gonna take advantage of this really cool setup. But let's just go ahead and do a couple things here. Let's see if Notion, let's see if Claude does have access to Notion. So let's just ask it, do you have access to my Notion? It should say yes, along with some functionalities that it can perform. Perfect. Yep. And this is the special one right there, the ability to create new pages and databases. So let's try that out real quick. Add a placeholder task to my task MCP database. So that's the database that I have right here. And this is what Notion AI can't do. It can summarize, it can generate text, but it can't actually perform work for you and execute within your Notion instance. So keep an eye over here, and we're gonna see a task pop up here in a second. This is super, super cool stuff. There it is. Placeholder task, sample entry. And trust me, I got some really cool use cases for you in the coming weeks. We're gonna be able to do a lot more than this, but I just hope that gets your mind going. Let your mind run wild. Test this out in the meantime. But yeah, got some cool stuff coming your way. Hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, feel free to reply to my newsletter, and I'll talk to you next week. Cheers.